Hello, everyone. Welcome to Space Zamboni. My name is Alex.
I'm Matt.
As you guys know, we are finally in Season 3 in terms of our content. This is the second Space Zamboni podcast of the month. Oh my God.
Yeah, it's going too quick.
So thank you to everybody who's subbed, liked, subscribed, you know, all that jazz. It really does mean the world to us. Channel members, Burgeritos, thank you for being a super sponsor. Mm-hmm. Formalities out of the way. We have a very special guest on the show today.
Oh, yeah.
Always say it, always true. Johnny Showtime.
What's going on, guys? I'm happy to be here. This is awesome.
Thank you for coming.
Yeah, no problem. I know a couple of weeks went by and like we kept trying to reschedule and stuff, but you know, life gets hectic and you know, but hey.
Did you have to pause the drop for us or was it already paused?
So the drop was already going to be paused for 2 weeks for Thanksgiving, just so I could take time to myself and then, you know, enjoy Thanksgiving and, you know, plus around the holidays, it's a little tough to, you know, sell ice cream to people. They're trying to, you know, save their calories for the actual holiday, you know? So, makes sense.
But everyone knows, like, Ralph's is closed. We can't go to Ralph's.
Yeah, that's true.
We gotta get the ice cream drop. We can't go to Ralph's.
I know. Honestly, the business should pick up now that Ralph's is closed. If it doesn't, then I'm doing something wrong.
That's the whole business model will now be surrounded.
Exactly. Dude, I mean, I'm the type of person that'll sit in the freaking Chick-fil-A parking lot on a Sunday and sell chicken sandwiches. I don't give a shit. You gotta do what you gotta do to make some money, you know?
100%. If we could do this live stream in front of like a famous streamer's house, we would.
Oh, Markiplier.
Hey, what's up?
Exactly.
Welcome to Markiplier's house.
That would be phenomenal.
So, who the fuck are you?
Who am I?
Yeah, who are you?
I'm Johnny fucking Showtime.
Hell yeah, you are, dude. Play the intro, that's it.
That's the old gimmick. We don't play with that anymore. I'm John Lombardi. You know, I am the owner. Co-owner, because my fiance is obviously a big part of it as
Congratulations.
Well.
Congratulations.
Thank you, by the way. Thank you. Yeah, Mrs. Showtime. She's a great woman. I love her. So we make ice cream. We do drops every Tuesday at 7 p.m. We do four different flavors, and, you know, you order your stuff, you come pick it up, and then you go home and enjoy.
That's awesome.
That's pretty cool.
Thank you.
Formed that? How did you get to that point anyway?
I always joked about when I got a house, I would buy a soft serve ice cream machine. Okay. Like one of the ones that you would see at like Mr. Softy or like any of these other soft, like
TCBY.
Yeah, TCBY, like places like that where you just go up to the machine, the ice cream's already churning there, and you pull down a lever and you just make a quick cone. And it was just an ongoing joke. And then one day, I was let go from my job due to COVID. And COVID. Did you just Jim Jones that?
Oh, my God.
Phenomenal. Honestly, we're like 2 minutes in, and this is the greatest podcast I've ever been on. And so I said to my fiance, I said, look, like, I have time to sit around while I'm looking for other work. Like, why don't I just go ahead and buy a machine?
No.
She's like, okay.
Sweet.
It was free ice cream to her, so like, what was she going to say? So we made like a couple batches, and I looked at her, I said, this is good shit. Like, we know what we're doing. And I always was on Facebook too, especially during COVID. You saw so many people making like baked goods, like side hustle
meth
bread.
Yeah, that was mine.
Meth. Oh, Facebook Marketplace.
Facebook Marketplace. Yeah. You saw all these people. They were doing
crazy
crudité boards, charcuterie boards. Yeah. That's a new word for it, apparently. Yeah. And then cheese and meat, baked goods. Cheese and meat. So a nice salumi, you know. Now charcuterie. Like, how fucking white can you get?
COVID changed everybody. Yeah. Yeah. They got all fancy.
But you know, you see all these people selling all these crazy things on Facebook, and no one was doing ice cream. And I was like, damn, this is definitely something that I could hit.
Got some product.
I did. I definitely did. I definitely brought some good ice cream for you boys.
Sweet.
Whoa.
Thank you.
Whoa. Salem Wax Museum. That's I brought crazy. Down the wrong bag.
Oh, you man.
Brought
down the
Welcome to the Salem Wax Museum. How the hell did this get here?
I can't wait to try that.
So the ice cream's probably sitting on the counter now, not in the free.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Man. I'm going to go grab it. But he gave us stuff from Salem. Johnny, what are you doing, dude?
Dude, I haven't been in Salem in like
you,
3 years.
You
man.
Drove out to Salem for a gag?
Oh, my God.
I'm going to grab it.
Absolutely. I brought a couple flavors from some past drops and stuff. Mm,
this
so.
Is cool.
Oh, thank you. That was actually the first thing that we worked on was the logo.
That's crazy. Dang.
Yeah, I had a few people working on it. And then, it transformed into this, which is super cool. The spoon is a J.
Oh, dang. Yeah.
For you to check. Why is there nothing in this?
Oh, that's mine.
Oh, okay. I didn't see the logo? It got the little spoon and the cone in there. I was about to say, I said, bro, you
ate the whole thing.
I was running.
Yeah. Although that is a really good flavor, the banana nata. That's one
that
of
was
the
really
top
good.
Ones. Thank mm-hmm. you. Well, I'm glad that it, made its way down here.
It almost didn't. I was just going to end the video and just eat all of these. So this is the product. And it's at Johnny's Ice Cream Drop. Oh, yeah. Instagram and Facebook.
Mm.
What do you find to be better in terms of selling product?
Instagram. Mm. Our generation is definitely more gravitated towards Instagram. Facebook, I kind of feel like, is died off for people around our age. Now it's more of like the older generation on it, which is fine. But honestly, like 99% of the business is strictly off Instagram. Mm. I just kind of have the Facebook kind of like for shits and gigs, I guess. You know.
What about cool. TikTok?
Oh, God. I can sell orders on TikTok.
Pay up a bunch with the ice cream in your hands.
Welcome to
my... Yeah. Dude, I would cry for you. The day I see you on TikTok.
Have
like
you
this.
Seen on TikTok doing that? Yeah.
Man, I'll put you down. Don't worry.
Yeah, I was going to say, you see me on TikTok dancing with the ice cream, yeah. Just come on over and put two right in my head, honestly.
He bought Yeezys.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Dude, holy shit. You got to do the ice cream drop dance.
Yeah.
The sweet and salty style dance.
Gee, come up with a cool dance to a TikTok song. Maybe Skyscraper.
By
Demi Lovato.
What the hell does that have anything?
Oh, no, because the ice cream's out of this world.
Yeah.
She could sing to it. It'll beat back at her.
Oh, my God.
Did you see this? There's an actual video he's referencing.
Yeah.
Demi Lovato hunts aliens now.
Yep. Let me tell you something about that girl.
Yay!
What the fuck is wrong with her?
I have no
clue. A lot of things.
I really, no I really
she's
don't
part
care.
Alien.
We watched her on American Idol, and we were like, oh, yeah, she's normal. And then all of a sudden, it's like, oh, we're doing heroin now. It's yeah, like, how does American Idol and then go to heroin? And now, all of a sudden, you can't use the word alien in her life.
Yeah, it's literally. 100%.
Oh, crap, that's right.
Yeah, extraterrestrial.
Yeah, it is extraterrestrial. Yeah. Damn
and
it.
She hunts them like ghosts? That makes no sense.
Man, you're talking about putting people down. No, I'm just kidding. No, I didn't mean that. But God bless her. She's...
Yeah.
She needs Jesus, I think.
Well, no, whatever extraterrestrial needs to reach out and sit her down and be like, Demi.
Yeah, I feel like she needs Scientology.
Yeah. Remember a couple of years ago they were offering to send people to Mars?
Yeah. Yeah,
fucking send her.
That would have been good. Mm. She would have loved that too.
Yeah.
Can we still do that? Can we?
I think the plan actually got kind of shut down. I think it might have been just like, a lot of hoopla.
Mm.
But whatevs. I mean,
her application's probably in the mix.
Honestly, it really wouldn't shock me.
Maybe she did submit it.
Yeah.
Maybe she submitted, they sent her heroin.
Yeah, oh my God.
And that was the slope.
Yeah. That's like, we can't have her go in this spacecraft. We gotta get her out of the mix somehow.
Who knows?
See, when you used to be Showtime Unplugged, and I'm still plugging it, even though you're not currently.
That's fine. Anyone. It'll make a comeback.
Hell yeah. So, it's one of the only podcasts on our website. Mm-hmm. That's not produced by us because we were like, oh, this thing's fucking dope. Love the way you do it.
I'm honored.
So, and you got the podcast voice.
Thank you. Thank you. It all comes down to the announcing gigs that I used to do. But also, Podient was the host of my podcast, and they've been charging an expired credit card for months now.
Wow.
So, geez. I don't know what to do about that situation.
Wow. What?
Whatever. It's still up. You can listen to it. Yeah. You can still listen to everything.
They'll listen to it before they hear this podcast.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
Like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
He's right. Check the statements.
Oh, my God.
So,
not my job.
Do you want to bring that back? Is that something that you are interested in bringing
honestly,
back?
It definitely is something I would like to bring back. I definitely really enjoyed doing it. I mean, you were on it. You had a good time. We had a couple people from StatFest was on it. We had John Arpino on it. We had some pro wrestlers on it. I mean, it was cool. I definitely enjoyed it. I mean, to me, it was more of just being able to show people that weren't paying attention to other people that are actually doing big things.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. One of my favorite things to do is to support and, like, kind of showcase other people that are, you know, doing awesome things. Because, you know, everyone lives a busy life. Not everybody is scrolling through the internet, you know, looking for every little thing. So any exposure you could help people to push, you know, their gimmick, their story, whatever it is, like, I'm always there to do it.
No,
social media to me is, like, you know, kind of like a fake world. So I don't give a fuck what I post. You know, if I'm sharing some shit that's, you know, going to help someone out, so be it, you know.
That's an interesting take. People already think we're currently living in the Matrix.
So yeah, it is the Matrix. Yeah.
I mean, if there's people out there saying that in 2012, the world actually did end, but...
Oh, my God. Then we were plugged in?
Whoa.
Yeah. Who knows, dude?
That's crazy.
I don't remember that at all, if it did end.
Yeah, I mean, I was hanging out at my home, and I didn't feel anything different, so...
It's 2013, all right?
Yeah, pretty much.
That movie fucking sucked, too. Did you see that movie?
No, I don't like to get disappointed, so I don't watch shit like that.
What's the movie that you went in for that you were super excited, and then you came out, and you're like, fuck.
Damn. Bird Box. Oh. And I'll tell you why. Because everyone and their mother hyped that up to be this incredible thing, and it was so fucking stupid.
Yeah, it was so stupid. 2.0.
There was also another... Tiger King. I'm sorry for everybody out there that loves Tiger King. I love Joe Exotic. I think he's incredible, and I think he should be let out of jail, and Carol Baskin should be in jail. But that was one of those things that was so hyped up, and I watched it, and I'm sitting there like, what are we doing? Like, why are we doing this? And now Tiger King 2 is out, and I can assure you it's the most over-exaggerated bullshit production you'll ever see.
So funny story about that is that I was, like, super hyped for it, too. I was going to watch it, never got the chance. Mm-hmm. And then recently, after season 2 premiered, they said that they found Carol Baskin's husband.
Whoa, what?
Yeah.
Where?
Apparently, alive?
Yeah, alive.
What?
He's alive.
Oh, my God.
And apparently, she might have been doing something for a big insurance fraud. So,
damn,
she's been alive. And, you know, everyone's like, oh, Carol Baskin killed her husband. Yeah. Like, there was songs, there was fucking everything. And now they're like, oh, well, he's alive. He's out in this weird remote location.
Oh, well.
So
he's living with, like, primates.
Where was he?
Fact check. Let's do it. Let's pull it up.
I'm really curious because, like, no one saw him. Like, he just disappeared. He literally disappeared.
He just lived in the Amazon. He's eating grubs with Timon and Pumbaa.
Carol Baskin was curious about missing husband being alive.
I was absolutely shocked.
That the whole world was shocked. Yeah. Look at her eyes.
Yeah, I thought I killed him. Yeah.
That's one. That is one crazy bitch.
Get out of here, you stupid plugins. Well, do you want to watch it? Let's see.
Yeah.
I was absolutely shocked. I had to watch Tiger King 2 because I knew people would be just, you know, carried away by the narrative like they were the first time around. But when they presented,
what the hell does it say at the bottom? Carol Baskin's cake fart.
Security.
Cake fart.
Well, 5 years after I saw it.
Oh, cage fight. Yeah.
And then I reached out to the FBI and
what
said,
"A gorgeous man he is."
I want to know what that says because part of it was redacted, and I don't know who the people involved were. So I don't know how long it'll take for me to get that, but I'm really curious about that.
So that's interesting, if her husband is actually alive.
If anyone should be smacked right in the face, it's definitely her.
Declared dead in 2002, and so apparently the feature claims that Lewis is alive and living in Costa Rica.
Wow.
Wow.
That's crazy.
Wow.
That's He's got crazy. Like a tiger as a wife.
Isn't that like the...
Who knows? They're weird people.
The rumor about Hitler, too, right? They're like, he escaped. He's alive. He's hiding out in Brazil.
Yep.
I'm like, here's this photo of him in Brazil.
She's got, look like, crazy eyes. Face. Yeah,
she's creepy, man.
She looks like CGI'd.
Yeah, I don't even want to look at her anymore. She's so creepy.
Yeah, that's like a cursed image.
Yeah, it is.
It's
it
scary.
I would be fucking livid if people were, like, bombasting me over something. Like, Alex killed Gianna, and then it's like, no, she's right here. She's right here.
No, she's been living in the rafters the entire time.
Did you look her up?
That is funny. Did anyone really like bother to go looking for this guy? Like,
it took two seasons.
Yeah,
like a real life drama.
It took almost 20 years to find him.
Unbelievable.
So, going back to ice cream really quick, I have this question.
Sure.
When you use your machine, do you get the big bags? Or how does the shipment of ice cream work?
It's homemade, man.
Mm. Sweet. Thank God.
Yeah. Okay. No, I, when the beginning, when I was planning out costs and everything, I did think about getting the bags, but then I was like, honestly, that's, I don't know. I don't know the words for it, but I just kind of, also like the space to store it was definitely a little ridiculous. It doesn't really take much to mix heavy cream, milk, sugar, and flavoring, and then, you know, for chocolate, adding cocoa powder, and, you know. It's
fucking perfect.
Thank you. Yeah, honestly, all, like, the base of ice cream is a very simple base. Mm-hmm. It's just a matter of adding what flavor to it, and then, you know, putting in the machine, and then adding what toppings, and, you know, to get technical, the technical term would be inclusions.
Mm.
Learn that one at my new job. Thank you, Empire Bakery.
What a PC term for ice cream.
You can't exclude anyone.
Yeah, no. Nobody's excluded in ice cream. Yeah. Everybody's welcome.
That's true. Unless you're lactose intolerant.
Yeah, that's the only thing.
Then you shit out of luck.
Whoa, shit out of luck?
You got me on that one.
So, when I worked at McDonald's, like, it was my first job. And there they had, like, the big fucking bag. So I have, like, bad memories of that big fucking bag. And I'd bring it up. I'd be like, oh, okay, which one's chocolate, which one's ice cream, like, vanilla, which one's strawberry? Like, that's all of them.
Wow.
It's like this big, gross-looking bag. Keep in mind, this is the same place where they're like, if you smell lo mein too much, take a step outside for a little bit because you might shit yourself.
Stop it.
No, I'm serious. Yeah. Shitting yourself is a problem at McDonald's. Because the smell.
Oh, my God.
All the fried shit there.
Aerosolizing oil.
You might shit yourself.
Wow.
Can't trust a fart.
Let me tell you something. My brother worked at McDonald's for years, and they only gave him two pairs of pants. So.
Oh, my God.
You got to ask him. Do you have any shit? Yeah. He's like, no, your friend's weird. No, trust me.
I'm going to have to ask him. The only thing I knew that he used to do is take the frozen cookies and, like, punt them in the freezer, and they would explode into, like, millions of pieces.
Holy shit.
Yeah. And those cookies were good, man.
I was out of luck when I went there because I'm tan. So they went, oh, okay, maintenance worker. Oh, okay. So my job is literally changing the oil, filling the thing with the that gross bag of ice cream. Like,
damn.
It was rough. But when I saw that, I poured it into one machine, it came out three different flavors, I was like,
that's wild. How's that work? They just have like a flavor cartridge that it just pumps into, or
I just know that from what I saw there, can't imagine it ever being cleaned. That machine is never fucking cleaned.
Oh, 100%. I believe that the soda, that maybe the soda machine, fountain. Maybe the soda fountain. Because it's not too hard to clean one of those.
Yeah.
But the coffee, like the cold brew coffee machines and the ice cream machine, there is absolutely no way they are cleaning that. Because, like, you got to really hardcore take those things apart, you know?
Yeah. Mm. I never saw, like, even when we made a cup of coffee, they'd fill up the pot and they'd leave it there until it was empty. They did not make, like, two new pots. Oh, it's been here for a long time. That's gross. No, it was just sat there on the thing.
I believe it. I 100% believe it. I've seen some shit in my day in the restaurant business, man. And let me tell you, there's not a thing you could get by me that I'm going to go, oh, my God, no way.
I might have one.
I'm definitely down to hear it.
Let's see. Okay. So I was working there, maintenance worker. The way we clean the vats of oil, drain it into a big tub, get a brush, clean it out. Back in the tub, move it down. Basically, McDonald's use 8 days of oil. At the end, eighth day, that's Filet-O-Fish. That's literally the 8 day old oil is the Filet-O-Fish.
Damn.
Yeah. So then we clean it out. One day I come in, there's a new brush and new tools. I was like, oh, cool. They finally like fucking upgraded. Clean it out, fill them up. Like, I'm like, all done. The guy goes, did you use that brush? I was like, yeah. He's like, that new brush there? I was like, yeah, that's the toilet brush.
Wait.
I go, do you want me to redo it? They go, no, we got to do a lunch rush.
So that toilet brush...
8 days.
...was
of toilet already brush
oil. Yeah. In the toilet. It
yeah.
wasn't a brand new brush.
No, and it was in the vat machine already. Like, hey, use this brush. Like, who fucking puts it in the machine if it's not to be used for that thing?
Oh,
so,
man.
Yeah. That's, 8 days of, that's of toilet brush.
Which McDonald's was this?
I can't say. I don't want to...
All right, that's fine. You tell me off camera.
Yeah, well, I will. Know.
That's hysterical. Oh,
dude,
my
God. I couldn't fucking believe it. I was like, serious about this? You don't want me to redo it? Like, clean out a second time? No. Go.
I could say some really bad things, but a lot of people know the two restaurants that I worked in, and I'm not trying to
put
them under the radar. And
but was that bad? Was that... Have you heard something like...
I'm... Similar situations. I'm not gonna lie, man.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Wow. Because every time I tell someone that story, like, oh, that's gross. I can't believe it. And then, like, 4 weeks later, they're eating McDonald's.
Man, let me tell you something. I did an internship one time at this one place. Not one of the places that I, you know, was actually employed at. And this one guy was joking about cockroaches.
Mm.
And he's like, yeah, there's a lot of them here. I said, no way. He goes, yeah, there's a whole thing underneath the stove. You want to see? And I'm like, yeah, sure. What the hell? Thinking he's joking. He kicks the stove 3 times like he's fucking in The Wizard of Oz. And, bro, I'm telling you, like, I couldn't even count how many That's roaches came crazy. Running underneath and just were running around the whole kitchen. And I'm like, you guys cook in this kitchen with all these little motherfuckers? Yeah, man, no problem. I said, doesn't he get in the food? They're like, yeah, we make sure we pick it out.
Oh, my God.
That was the only day I worked at that internship. I literally went to my school. I said, absolutely fucking not. And they placed me somewhere else for the next 3 months.
That's crazy.
Gross. My God.
Yeah, I'm not into
that. Don't worry about it. It's clean.
Yeah, don't worry about it. It's just extra protein if it's in there.
Dirty clean.
Yeah. Man, I don't comprehend people's thought process when it comes to food. It's just like, I always go by, would you, like, feed your family like that?
No, absolutely not.
Would you eat that? And 99% of the time, the answer is no.
That's fucking crazy.
We've eaten those giant, like, water scorpions. They look like giant cockroaches.
We're not at a fucking restaurant. Yeah. They're like, by the way, it's in your food, baby. Mm. We picked it out.
Yeah, no big deal. A little fucking sachet de peace, you know?
All right, so we're actually going to go to a quick ad break. After that, we're going to talk some more to Johnny about flavors, how he chooses them, a bunch of different other stuff. So see you guys right after that. Much love. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the mid-podcast break. Today we have 5 different flavors of ice cream. We're going to try each one, guess the flavor, while answering some of Google's quote-unquote thought-provoking questions.
Whoa.
If you could have one superpower, what would it be?
I always liked invincibility.
Or invisibility.
Because I also like the idea of not being seen.
That's really good, yeah.
It's really, really good.
If you start breaking into hives, the superpower wish would be that you weren't allergic to nuts.
Yeah, I guess that.
I changed my answer completely.
I guess invincibility then. That way I can't get shoes.
Okay, so what's your guess for this flavor?
A brownie.
So the name for this flavor is sweet and salty.
Sweet and salty.
So hopefully the salty.
Oh, is it pretzel?
Which one do you want to do next?
That one.
Me and Matt love each other very much.
Hell yeah.
So we don't care about scooping into the same one.
Yeah, and I'm booster vaccinated.
Hell yeah, baby. Oh my God.
It's like a vanilla s'more.
If you were president and had to choose 3 people to assist you, who would you pick and why?
The lead singer of the 1975, because he would win people over by sucking on their fingers.
That's a good one, yeah.
Martha Stewart, because she can cook. And Snoop Dogg, because he knows how to party. And plus, him and Martha are good friends, so I feel like that they would have a good rapport together.
Mine was going to be you, Dan, and Gianna.
Oh, wow.
I'm going to be like you 3. Cookies and fluff.
Wow, cookies and fluff.
This is so tasty, dude. This is really, really, really good.
I wonder what those colors are.
That one tastes like just chocolate. Let's see.
It's like a chocolate cookie M&M.
When do you feel a teen becomes an adult? You never fully grow old.
Yeah. When you start paying taxes, I guess.
That is Eminem Frenzy. I want to get Eminem. I gotta go back in there. There you go, baby. Mm-mm. Would you rather stand for the rest of your life or sit for the rest of your life? You can only do one.
Ooh, that
one's
really good.
Mm. Oh, it tastes like graham cracker.
Yeah. Oh, that's what it is. Yeah, graham.
Tastes like graham cracker. That's super good.
Standing even for like 15 minutes, my legs feel like they're gonna fall off.
Why do I feel like this question's not fair? If you're sitting for the rest of your life, aren't you handicapped? That's fucked up question. The graham cracker one we had.
Yeah.
JR's Journey. Shout out to John. John Arpino. He's a really amazing guy. The other question before we move on to the last one. Would you rather have short, stubby arms, and they're up to here, but they're little hands, or long, lanky arms, but they're down to your feet?
I think I would rather have long, lanky arms. Ooh, that one's neat.
That's a banana.
Oh.
I could taste bananas. Banana Nana. So guys, if you are interested in trying out any of these flavors, these are actually all really flippin' good. So if you're interested in trying any of these flavors, go to Johnny Ice Cream Drop's page. We will link it right here so you can go straight to it.
Hey, it has some delicious tasty ice cream. Really good.
This one's actually, the graham cracker one is delicious.
Yeah. It's that would go good with that banana nana. Oh, that banana nana's got my food.
Yeah, I gotta throw these back in the freezer. These are sitting out the whole podcast.
Yeah.
I felt a little bad. But yeah, no, dude, shout out to Johnny. Great job. And we'll see you guys right back at the podcast. Peace and love.
Peace and love. Peace and love.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the part of the video where I stop everything to tell you about two different places. So, guys, if you aren't familiar, we have this one sponsor called Raise Energy. If you're not familiar with what they do energy drinks. They come in a bunch of different flavors. It's actually really cool and probably the most tasty energy drink I've ever had and the most vitamin-filled and natural energy drink I've ever had. Whenever I drink Raise Energy, I actually do not have a crash and I get to experience the full day of work. It's actually pretty cool. I frequently use it, and they also have pre-workout, post-workout, and a bunch of other stuff like that. So it's really cool. If you guys are interested in finding a clean, nice, great energy drink, check out Raise Energy if you aren't familiar. Also, are you in the business of having some fun, kinky fun? Well, guys, the Bunny Shop, if you're not familiar, go to their site. And it has a lot of great ways to spice up your intimate life. I'm talking a bunch of things that I can't say or I'll get demonetized. So... check it out. They have a lot of cool stuff there. They have a lot of unique stuff there. Check it out. Guys, much love. We're going to go right back to the podcast. Short little ad break. Much love. Love you guys. See you guys next time. Bye-bye. Guys, welcome back from the ad break. I'm going to situate my hat. Welcome back from the ad break. We hope you enjoyed whatever the hell it was. we're here at Johnny's.
You're so nuts. I love it.
For a while, whenever we did that, people were like, are you doing like Zoop House or something? I'm like, maybe. I would love to fucking buy Zoop House. What are they doing now?
Probably fucking nothing, honestly.
Exactly.
But those were pretty popular back in the day.
The ads are engraved in my fucking brain.
Ribbit, Zoop House. Zoop House make eating fun.
My parents are like, no fun for you. We're going to hit plate.
Yeah, I never had them. I always saw the commercials, too. At one time when I went home, one of my friend's house, he had them. I was like, can I take this home? I was like, this is cool as hell.
Oh, my gosh.
He's like, no, I want my eating to be fun.
Yeah, exactly.
Side note, pedicures. You still getting them?
Oh, man. I haven't gotten one in a while, let me tell you. But have you ever experienced
them? I always wanted one.
Bro, I've had a manicure.
I'm telling you right now. Anyone who hates on them is just afraid to be judged by other people while they're sitting there getting it done. And let me tell you something. Nobody fucking cares.
Yeah.
Nobody cares. I literally went there. Me and my fiance went because she was like, yeah, you should just do it. It's fun. And I was like, all right, look, I'm not doing anything today. Let's go. And the lady's like, oh, you getting a pedicure too? I said, yeah. I was like, yeah. She goes, oh, okay, great. I'm like, cool, come on. And I was like, all right. Sits me down. They start doing the water and stuff. You know, they massage your feet and everything.
Yeah.
The lady's like, oh, you have really nice feet. I'm like, fucking damn right. I got nice feet. But it's great. Honestly, they, you know, they obviously clip your toenails and stuff. They massage your feet, your calves. And then, you know, you want to do a little clear coat? You're more than welcome to. It's great. It definitely feels awesome. I highly recommend it.
No, yeah, I always wanted to do one. And Gianna's like, Gianna keeps saying, oh, Alex doesn't want to do one, but I'll go with Matt. Yeah, I'm like, take me.
Yeah, I always remember saying that you don't want to do.
I'll do it, dude. Just find me a good place, and that's it. I'll do it.
No, what she's got to do is just book the appointment and then just be like, oh, like, let's go get lunch. And then drive you to the place and, like, then say, all right, cool, like, let's go.
Yeah.
Mm. You know?
No, I'd be game. I wouldn't complain.
Hell yeah.
Do you know about this thing called Wiki Feet?
No, he's laughing. I'm nervous.
Yeah.
There's this thing called Wiki Feet. And we're on Wiki Feet Men.
Yeah.
You have to have an IMDb page to be on this website.
So there's Wiki Feet, which is, all right, boring old women's feet. And then
and then Wiki Feet Men.
Right.
Man.
So this is a site that's built entirely around actors and people's feet.
Mm-hmm.
So they'll take any photo they could ever find and be like, boom, Adam Sandler's toes.
Yeah.
Bam.
Yeah.
We got one shot on Instagram here. Boom.
And that one's watermarked as shit.
Yeah. Take the shot. Boom. Yeah.
Like, that one's from like Alamy or whatever. Alimony.
Yeah, so they literally find any, and the Wiki Feet regular is just women. So, like, it's the same exact thing, but.
Let me tell you something.
Less funny.
People have too much time on their hands today to be doing this stuff, man.
Yeah. So, when we did a charity stream, and I was like, oh, I'm on IMDb. I could have, like, a silly fucking photo. Yep. I was in a bean sauna. So I took the grossest fucking picture of my feet, and I put it on the site.
The bean sauce.
Yeah. You got three out of five stars.
Three stars, yeah.
Yeah.
I think Matt has the better feet.
Between the two of us? Because Matt's also on there.
Matthew Patrick, that's me.
Yeah, and what? This is... Oh, yeah, 3.6. Got a better score than me. They're like, oh
my God.
But look, yours is flattering. Mine's in beans.
Yeah. Like, oh my God.
This guy deserves some extra stars.
A little extra.
And there was this a guy on YouTube. He was putting an YouTube ad before videos. Like, you know, right, chilling, watching a YouTube video. And it's him driving in his car. And he's like, if you live in New York, Suffolk County, Nassau County, I want videos of you driving barefoot. And he goes, I'll pay you. And then, it went on this whole crazy adventure on, like, the H3 podcast. And
dang.
Then, like, God. At first, I'm like, who the hell is this guy? And he goes, I'll be in Suffolk County next week. I was like, no, I could bump into him.
Yeah, that's crazy. Well, then you could drive around barefoot and it'll just throw money at you.
No, I don't think so, dude. He likes your feet. The clean, nice, mine are hairy as fuck, dude. Doesn't work.
Whatever.
He wants the clean feet.
Get the pedicure, then hit him up.
Oh my God. Unbelievable.
The perfect weekend.
Yes. Yeah. You'd be like, oh, Gigi, while we're out, I mean, I got to meet up with a friend now that we've got pampered a little bit.
She's like, why are your feet wet now? They weren't wet before.
She's like, your feet are all slimy. What is this? It smells like bleach.
I'm like putting the hundreds in my wallet. Yeah. Don't worry about it.
Don't ask.
This is my life now.
Oh, my God.
So how do you decide an ice cream flavor?
What a fucking segue that was. You had that shit set up, didn't you? Honestly, so I actually gave my fiance, Mrs. Showtime, the title of CEO of Flavors.
Cool.
So she definitely thinks of a lot of good ones. A majority of them include like her favorite things like peanut butter and s'mores.
Yeah. Mm.
And a lot of times I just shake my head. I'm just like, come on, like, there's more to the world than that.
Dang.
and that gets me a lot of heat. She actually will hit me if I say that. Damn. Yeah. But it's basically, I do take a lot of recommendations through DMs and stuff. I'll put up polls on the story like, hey, what do you think about this flavor? What do you think about this? To see what, you know, the clientele wants. Like, there's times where Statfest actually asked me to do a pineapple flavor, and I was kind of, like, nervous about it. So I put it up on the poll, and, like, no one really wanted pineapple. Which is weird, because I've had pineapple Dole Whip before. Have you ever had that?
Mm-hmm.
And it's like phenomenal. So I'm like, why don't people want this? And then like, I don't know, but I guess people aren't really that big of pineapple flavored fans. But
I think it's also like people get scared to go out of their comfort zone. Mm.
That's also it. Yes. Yes.
People, I want the typicals, chocolate, vanilla, M&M. Like,
yeah.
What about like masculine flavors like barbecued ribs, like a barbecue rib base milk, Matt, like chunks of pork in there.
This is toxic masculinity. What? Matt, what are you doing? This is toxic.
Fried chicken, like Hungry Man dinner. You blend up a Hungry Man dinner, throw it in. Milk.
Trying to kill someone? I've done a maple flavored ice cream with bacon in it.
Mm, that sounds awesome. Yeah.
And I told people when they were ordering, I said, trust me, you order this one with your regular order, like you're not going to be disappointed.
Yeah.
And like people were like kind of nervous about it, but like the reviews back for it, they were like, dude, that was phenomenal. Because you get both worlds. You get the nice sweet and you get the salty. And then like, together, I mean, who doesn't love bacon too?
Yeah, big time.
Tiana picked up from you, I thought twice, three times, something like that. And she brought it home. She goes, this one's for you. This one's mine. Like you love like Snickers and stuff. Got home. She has mine open, eating out of it with the spoon. I'm like, John, I thought that was mine. She goes, yeah, but you could still have it. I'm just trying. I was like, holy shit. Oh, no. I'm like, I'm not going to have ice cream. Man. So then I took out a spoon. I did the same. I'm like, try each one before they're gone.
If I had a nickel for every time told me that, I'd have a lot of extra money, man. People will send me like screenshots of their like alarms set before 7 o'clock. At like 6:59, so they don't forget.
Wow.
People will accidentally send me their order at like 6:50 and be like, oh no, I was just typing it out, sorry. Yeah, I'm telling you, people get wild.
And, wow.
Honestly, I love it. I appreciate the hell out of it, the fact that people would even like consider buying ice cream.
That's awesome.
You know, I'm making it out of my house.
And having something local is super cool. Like,
Awesome. We'll see one day. Maybe it blows up, and you know, I can open up like a storefront or even like an ice cream truck. Tell me that wouldn't be sick. Just be cruising down the street and like
that'd be amazing.
Yeah, you know, but you know,
ice cream RV
in due time.
Be better than all the other ice cream trucks that are out there.
Yeah, Circus Man.
Oh, I used to work for that.
Did you really? Yeah. You worked for the place or you drove?
Oh no, I worked in there. I was stocking all the vendors.
Really?
Yeah, at How like 15. It's a madhouse.
Oh, man.
It was the craziest job I ever had.
Really?
Well, one of them.
I don't know. I mean, the Circus Man is cool because they have, like, you know, all, like, the nostalgia stuff. But, I don't know. For me, I'm more into, like, actual, like, ice cream.
No, are they still around? 100%. Because I know they used to be...
Is Circus Man the one with the melted Sonic face?
They would have all of those pops. Yeah. The most melted face.
The SpongeBob pops and the Choco Tacos.
Choco Tacos, the wrestling bars. Did you ever have the wrestler bars? Those are so good.
The WWE ice cream bars were fit. They brought them back, but they brought back like a shitty version of
that sucks.
We had it later.
It was more of just a sandwich. They didn't have it on a stick with the chocolate on the end.
Yeah.
And it was like four wrestlers. It was like Becky Lynch, who was cool. John Cena, I think The Rock or Stone Cold, and then like The Ultimate Warrior. Mm-hmm. It was like a very weird combination of people. But back then, they had the cool guys. They had like The Rock, Triple H, Stone Cold, The Undertaker, Kane. Like, you know.
Eat a Roman Reigns bar.
First off, don't have me on your podcast and disrespect my tribal chief. I hate Roman Reigns, please. I fucking love him.
Well, maybe I wasn't saying it sarcastically.
I would hope not. You better acknowledge him.
Oh my god!
You better sit here and acknowledge your title, chief.
Oh my god! Well, who do they have on them now? Who's on them now?
When they brought Doink.
Doink. No, not Doink. That would be fucking amazing, though.
Undertaker's tombstone.
Oh my gosh! Yeah. Kane the politician.
Just a Joe Biden. Joe Biden.
When did he wrestle?
Hey, he wrestles now.
Oh my god! That would actually infuriate so many people if Joe Biden was on ice cream. Which is crazy.
They could do a Trump one, right?
Yeah.
They could. Yeah. And, you know,
he was in the ring.
Yeah. Oh my
Let me tell you something. He was like in almost the main event of WrestleMania back then.
He almost got his head shaved.
That's true.
Yep.
Yeah. And he took a Stone Cold Stunner.
Yeah.
Twice, actually, I think. Oh, what a man. That guy.
He's strong.
I don't even know what to say about him sometimes. But he's fucking entertaining, I'll tell you that.
Then he's like a 9th-degree judo master now.
Yeah, I wish his Twitter was still up so we could see stuff. Because now it matters less.
Yeah.
It's not like, oh, hey, I tweeted this. It's law. So it would be cool to see, like, what he's saying now. I can only imagine the shit he'd still be sending out.
I think he's suing, like, Twitter and, like, Facebook and a bunch of people. Which, you know, I get it. Do your thing.
You know? You do you, baby.
Yeah.
I would watch, dude, a fucking boxing match with Trump and Biden in the
ring. Oh, my God.
Who wouldn't watch that? I would watch his shit.
Yeah, that would definitely get more buy-ins than, like, Pacquiao Mayweather.
I mean, I would watch Trump versus Pacquiao.
Oh, my God.
I would probably be more interested in watching Biden and Trump get in the ring than fucking Jake Paul.
Oh, yeah, 100%.
Honestly,
yeah.
Like...
Yeah, Jake Paul's...
Good for him making money and hustling everybody, but at the same time, it's like, bro, come on.
They should just do Jake versus Logan, and then that'll be the last one. And yeah. It's gone. One, well, it's to the death, though.
Oh, my God.
But it's got to be held in the Coliseum.
Yeah.
You know, just... Yeah. And then send out fucking lions and shit and be like, oh, wait, my bad. We didn't know we still had these here.
New edition. Jake, yeah. Logan versus lions.
Wow, that is nuts.
That would be something. We might be onto something.
I think so.
Shit, hopefully watch
Hit us up. Hit us up.
Yeah, pretty much. We'll help you, Bucky.
Have you seen... Because we're talking about shitty flavors and...
Nathan For You?
Yeah, this. Have you seen Nathan For You?
No. Who's this?
So this is
I don't do a lot of, like, YouTubing, unfortunately.
Oh, he was on Comedy Central.
Mm-hmm. Comedy Central, yeah, okay. Yeah.
But he made a poo-flavored yogurt
because this business wasn't doing well. And he's like, okay... This is what I want you guys to do. I want you to make a new flavor for one day and make it poo. And then everyone's going to come into your shop. Mm-hmm. So he does like crazy marketing to like the weirdest degree. And this, I wonder if I could find, we'll do the short clip. Because he was, there's a part where he's in the store. And he goes, oh, what flavors do you have? He goes, oh, I got cherry, vanilla, and poo. It's like, this guy is nuts. I would highly recommend his stuff.
Yeah, I'll definitely try.
Mission was to fill Yogurt Haven with customers. My plan: a crazy new flavor that will get people talking. That flavor is poo.
Get that already.
Is that serious? Any response to controversy? I feel like a poo yogurt might be a new story. People read the paper.
This guy wants to smack the shit out of him right now.
To thousands of people in here, maybe, or
just to try that flavor. Yes.
I really needed to sell my idea. The first step was to actually create the new flavor. I found a company.
And he goes all out.
Yeah.
He does the craziest fucking shit.
We're not allowed to say no. We'll always try to formulate anything.
After a week of waiting, the flavor was ready, so I went to the Gold Coast Island in California to pick it up.
This is what you requested. We call it artificial feces.
Is there a real...
There's no actual, it's completely edible. If you could eat this.
Right.
But if you wanted to dilute it
to yogurt?
You could make yogurt.
I didn't want to be the first to try it, but I needed to know if the taste was accurate. So I conducted a taste test with some strangers. So I'd like everyone to try the frozen yogurt.
Oh my God.
Yuck.
What does it taste like?
It's peppermint.
Peppermint?
Kind of like licorice.
Like, oh, there's another. Yeah, closer.
It's got some other familiar.
This guy's onto me.
What does this taste like to you?
Poo.
It's a wheel.
What were you basing that on?
Well, clearly the luck helps.
Right.
The color.
Because it was amazing how quick.
So he eventually does actually put it into the store. Mm-hmm. And
let me tell you something. If you had me do a taste test, and you sat me down and said, "Here, I need you to taste this. Let me know how it is." And it's poop flavored stuff. I'm beating the shit out of
you. Whoa! I would try.
Right? Wait, you would? You'd totally be happy. Try. I mean, if I they didn't try. Tell you, if they didn't tell you what it was, they just said, "Here, have."
I would be very disappointed.
Really? I'd be like,
"What if they're like, it's gone?"
Well, I'd still eat it. I would try.
What if they're like, "It's no, it's not flavored. This is cum and ice cream."
Frozen cum? Is it clean cum?
Already too many questions. Imagine if it
an easy no.
Oh. I sat here looking at you. I was like, I gotta see his answer. This is insane.
How clean is it?
Yeah. Was the person tested before they put it in the cream?
That's what you're worried about. Yeah. Not the fact that it's cum. Just the fact that it's clean.
Yeah.
Okay. To each of its own.
It's a good concern, but still.
Yeah. It just tastes like bleach. Just be like tasting bleach water, whatever.
Oh my God. I'm fucking dead.
So, you know, if you ever do a cum drop, he's going to feed them.
Oh, yeah, I'd be like.
Sold out.
He's going to buy me out.
As long as it's clean.
Yeah, it'll have to have, it'll have the tested. Normal logo and at the bottom.
Yeah.
Tested.
I'm going to have to take the ice cream to like Planned Parenthood before I put it in my mouth.
Oh my God. Man.
Get it yeah.
Where the hell am I right now?
Welcome to the Space Nipples podcast.
Holy shit.
I too would hate getting poo yogurt though. Mm. I would be very upset.
Yeah, I would be, honestly.
Did you ever go out east and have like sweet corn ice cream?
No. Are you going to say it's cum? What are you about to say?
No, it could be if you want it to be. Sweet corn.
No, sweet corn.
Yeah.
Unless Wait, that's so why'd you ask that?
Unless that's why they, that's what... They do out east, I don't know. But I've had sweet corn ice cream. You'd think it would be gross, but it's really good.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I was like, where are you going? Because we just talked about poop and cum ice cream. Yeah. And you're like, sweet corn? Have you had
sweet
that?
Sweet corn? It's an unusual sounding thing, but it tastes good.
I feel like sweet corn could be good, right? No?
Mm. Yeah. I've seen goat cheese ice cream.
Ooh, before. That sounds good.
It kind of tasted like a cheesecake almost.
Mm. Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah, really interesting.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Blue cheese ice cream.
When you do these new flavors, what's your testing process? Fiance?
It would be me, Mrs. Showtime.
Yeah.
My brother, my mom, who is the toughest critic in the entire world. Yeah. She's very hard to please.
Wow.
Dang. Well, her problem is she doesn't like a lot of inclusions. Mm. She doesn't like a lot of pieces in it, so like it's hard for her to get the full effect if she like can't stand like big chunks of chips and BS or whatever we put in it. But you know, she's always honest with me, which is good because you always need someone who's gonna like, you know, tell you like, nah, this is not good, don't do this. So yeah,
the good news is from all the ones I've had so far, there hasn't been one that I'm like, oh no. I literally, they're all fucking great.
Oh, well, thank you.
They're all really good.
I appreciate it, man. Thank you very much.
One, like, what's your goal? Where do you, in a few years, like, where are you? What are you doing?
I don't know. It's not really, I don't like to set a goal on this, mainly because I'm just enjoying doing what I'm doing sure. now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
If an opportunity comes about and it makes sense and it's, you know, plausible, then, you know, decide at that point in time. But as of right now, like, I'm enjoying selling it straight out of my house, you know, seeing people come pick up and, like, you know, having conversations mm-hmm. stuff with them. Like, it's kind of like a weekly catch-up with everybody that picks up. You know, we hang out, we talk for a couple minutes, you know, and then we're on to the next week, you know. So that's, I don't really have a goal set to it yet. No, but, you know, awesome. I'm not going to, you know, frown upon anything that comes about out of it, you know.
Yeah, Facebook started out of a house.
Yeah.
That's true. Very true.
A lot of places started out of a house.
Yeah.
Mm. No, but and just life wise, where do you want to be? You just want to be chilling.
I just want to be happy, man.
Hell yeah.
That's pretty much best. It. Mm. You know, plan on, you know, buying a house relatively soon, and then just trying to live the American dream. You know,
100%.
That's about it. You know, I try to keep life simple. You know.
No, that's the best way to live. Is just enjoy stuff, have fun with stuff, and. Regardless of outcome, just make sure you're having a good time. Exactly. That way at the end, you're like, you know what? I had fun.
Exactly, man. Exactly.
Mm-hmm. So before we end, I just want you to plug one more time where everyone could find your stuff.
Sure. You could find me at Johnny's Ice Cream Drop on Instagram, on Facebook. I post daily and you'll see stories and stuff of what like, I like to do flavor hints during the weekend I'm making the ice cream. So then people could be like, oh, I wonder what that'll be. And then they tune in on Tuesday when I drop the flavors in the morning and see if they're right. Sometimes I do contests of, you know, to give away free ice cream and stuff or a lot of polls and the stories and stuff. So, you know, definitely follow it. It's definitely a cool little journey that I'm, you know, on and doing. And Get yourself a nice $5 cup of ice cream. Yeah. I promise you, you'll love it.
I wish you nothing but success, dude.
Thank you, man. So I appreciate it.
I know. We don't have Dan here. He usually switches, so I needed a timer. But yeah, no, seriously. You're a cool guy. Everything you do it such, like, you do it the best way you can, and you're always fucking rocking it. So shout out literally everything you do.
Thank you. And shout out to you guys, too. I mean, you guys are always killing it, too.
Appreciate
it.